So we're actually headed up Salma Plateau. Salma Plateau is located, it's in between Fins and Ibri. Mountaintop known as the tabletop of Oman has a couple of really cool places like Kaf Mersijin, which is seventh largest in the world if I'm not mistaken, and of course the Jaila tombs, which are more than 5,000 years old. So this is going to be epic because this is considered to be one of the best off-roading tracks that you can take on this side of Oman. Since this was a last minute trip, we made our pit stop at Sultan Center in Adeba, got our supplies and got ready to make a move. Alright, خلصنا نعبي السيارة. We're done with Sultan Center, you can see behind me. Guys are ready, all packed up. Since again it was a last minute trip, took us a little bit of time to put everything together, but I think we're set and we are ready to make a move towards Salma Plateau. We still don't know whether we're going the fence route or the Ibra route, but should be fun. Discussing it, we thought that going up Ibra and coming down Tiwi was the best option for us.
Hey Jamaat, guys, we've reached the two tunnels. I've done these tunnels so many times in the past couple of weeks, but here we go again.
Pit stop. Get some food before we go. We're running really late today. Guess who's with us?
Yeah!
Ready to go, man. I'm looking forward to this trip.
It's gonna be sick.
Should be. It's actually one of the best, or what it says online is one of the best off-roading routes.
Yeah, it's definitely intense. There's quite a few nice twists and turns. It's fun.
He's our guide today because I haven't been there before.
It should be interesting. He'll be our anchor.
I don't trust him, but yeah, we'll see how it goes. Alright guys, so we have reached Al Mu'tarad and we still have a little bit more to go before we turn for the off-roading track up to Salma Plateau. It's about 3 p.m. We're really behind schedule. I hope we get up before it gets dark. But this is Al Mu'tarad. At Ismailia, we took a right turn heading into Wadi Khabba. And not too far from the turnoff, you will end up on an ungraded track, or what we call in Oman, Gargara. I'm gonna air down the tires a bit, and then make a move.
So what?
So we're airing down to about 30 PSI just to make sure that it's smooth going up, gives us a little bit more traction and less bounce on the car as well.
So I'm actually running in front to get this shot. This is behind the scenes stuff. But currently we're down in the Wadi and we're gonna be heading up the mountain soon. You guys can see that up ahead. Looks amazing. All right, I'm gonna go. Time for the shot.
And as we went down the Wadi towards the mountains, I started to realize why this was one of the most extreme off-road tracks you could do this side of Oman.
So we got a bit lost up here in the mountains, but we found our way back. Finally decided to listen to the Garmin and not to myself. Actually not to Taha, because Taha is the one who got us into the trouble. So yeah, some sort of civilization on our way up there.
Following the Garmin, we made our way up the mountain. Some of the most amazing views that I have ever seen. The track is very demanding and is definitely not for the faint-hearted. A few more climbs and we made it to the Kibbeh tombs. And this was our campsite for the night. This, right behind me, is one of the Jaila tombs. Now, these tombs date back to about 2000 to 2700 before Christ. That's about 5,000 years old, if not more. Now, they were found when a German expedition was flying over the area, trying to sort and look at different archaeological sites in the country. And they spotted these, and there are 90 of these all around the ridges here. Beautiful to look at, a small opening to go in from. I don't know if I have the guts to go in, don't know if I should go in, but they're definitely something that you really have to see. It makes you wonder when you look at a place like this that's so desolate and so far off and so high up. We're about 1,800 meters above sea level, if not more. It makes you wonder, what's the story behind these? Standing about 3 meters tall and conical in shape, they command a dramatic position on the edge of the plateau and provoke plenty of unanswered questions. Locals here believe that they were built by the spirit Kibakib. That's why locally they're known as the Kibakib tombs. We found a spot next to the tombs and set up camp for the night. As soon as it turned dark, out came the cameras. We did manage to get some epic shots of the tombs and one epic shot of
the fire charcoal. Set up, charcoal's ready.
Who's hungry, guys?
Everyone.
Everyone's hungry.
Whether they admit it or not.
Dinner for today. It got down to about 20 degrees at night, but it was magical.
Morning. 7 in the morning, 7? 6:15 actually. The night was pretty cold, I passed out, I was tired. Sun's out.
After having a really quick breakfast, we packed up and started to head to our next destination.
Alright, so we're packed up and making a move towards Kehkemejis Jinn and then down to Fence, hopefully. There we go. Hey guys, so we are heading towards Kehkemejis Jinn. Check this out. So, we actually made it to Kehf Majlis al-Jinn. This thing is epic. Let me tell you guys a folk tale about this seventh largest cave that's located here in Oman. It's known as Kehf Majlis al-Jinn. The story goes, and this area is also known for Salma Plateau. So one of the fictionist stories is that Salma was a shepherd, and she got hungry and left her goats in a shaded area and went to get some food. And when she got back, she saw a leopard that had attacked or eaten a lot of her goats. And she had an axe, so she whacked him in the axe on the head, split his head open, but she was mortally wounded as well. And as the story goes, God took into account the courage that she had and sent down seven stars. And those seven stars are what make the seven entrances to Kehf Majlis al-Jinn. So this hole behind me is one of the entrances to Kehf Majlis al-Jinn. It is scary because you can't see anything all the way down. Nothing at all. I would not want to fall into this.
After spending a little time admiring the big hole in the ground, we made our way towards our exit to Tiwi. But we didn't know that the adventure was actually just getting started.
So guess what? Our trip has been cut a little bit short. Well, at least for the Tacoma. I don't know what exactly happened, but my front
right axle is totally busted. Totally busted. Look at this.
أيوة. طبعاً تعطلت سيارة مثل ما خبرتكم to the car. The front axle is gone, but some of the locals stopped as usual because this is Oman. وما شاء الله عليهم يعني. They're currently helping us out to fix the car. They're saying that we remove that side of the axle and we'll be able to drive the car down, which would save me a lot of money on a breakdown. But this is Oman, guys. This is what happens when you're stuck in the middle of nowhere. هذيل العمانيين ما شاء الله. طبعا ما قصروا وقفوا معانا حاولنا نصلح السيارة ما قدرنا نصلحها والحين ان شاء الله رتبوا لنا شخص طالع من تحت من طوي جاي بيصلح لنا السيارة وبنطلع. بس مثل ما قلت لكم هذه عمان.
So we waited for the mechanic to come up from Tiwi and the boys decided to put together a second breakfast. But that gave me a chance to sit down with some of the elders in the village and get to know a few of the local folklore stories.
صالح الوالد خبرنا بعض القصص عن المنطقة.
حقيقة ما أعرف بالضبط لكن حسب ما يقول الشياب قلنا ما ينسبوها للجن. الشياب أنا ينسبوها للجن قلنا
I asked Saleh about the Kebekeb tombs and he told me one of the local folklores was that it was built by a jinn called Kebekeb and that him and his children still live in those tombs. After listening to many amazing stories and having dates and coffee, Saeed Al-Muqaymi, an amateur mechanic, all the way down from Tui arrived and we were able to push the axle back in enough for me to drive it down the very steep inclines, the exit to Tiwi. In normal circumstances, with a fully functioning 4x4, this track is considered to be one of the most difficult in this part of the country. And I had to go down these steep inclines without my front axle working properly and without four low because I could not engage into four-wheel drive. This was one of the scariest but one of the most amazing drives I have ever done in Oman.
نزلنا تحت والبريك داون قاعد ينتظر الحمد لله وصلتنا والحين بنركبها وبنطلع ان شاء الله
Coming down those steep inclines with no 4x4 and with a broken front axle was one of the scariest drives I have ever done. But this trip was epic. After securing the taco onto the tow truck, we got it to Wadi Kabir, dropped it off, and made our way home after a very long but amazing day. Oh yeah, and I almost forgot. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. And we'll be back with more adventures soon.